Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
Hey everyone, NS Train Mod 22, and yes, it has arrived. Sorry if it sounds weird the way I'm talking. I have a cough drop in my mouth. I'm slowly getting over a cold. That's why I haven't been doing layout stuff in the past couple days or weeks. I've been sick. Just my allergies really kicking my butt. But I'm doing a small like review on this. Not that big. The layout is getting better with like progress. I moved the table back over to where it should be against the window and got the floor cleaned up a little. So that will be shown in a couple that'll be shown in later videos. Let me turn my phone on silent. And there's my girlfriend on my phone, just because I don't know if she watches my videos. She probably doesn't. But she's currently at her house laying in bed because she's sick. The warranty card just fell. And I'm sitting at my desk right now. My desk is a mess. I know I have to clean my desk up. So I got my work gloves up there for trucking and everything. And just hockey pucks I have to put away. But I got a warranty card. Limited warranty. It's hard to talk with the cough drop in my mouth. For Horizon Hobby. I'm gonna put that back in my drawer here. I put all my stuff in there. So the exploded parts diagram, just your typical stuff from Athens. So I don't need to show you all this or the unboxing, and the warranty card itself, basically garbage. The box is amazing looking. Air Force One, the presidential seal, presidential library and museum, Union Pacific Building America. They even went all out with the item number here, 4141. Union Pacific President George H.W. Bush SC7ACE 4141. Mine has LED like they all do, but mine's non-sound because I don't have a decoder yet and I don't want sound, just because. Nice metallic silver here. So hold on, computer's being stupid. There we go. Sorry about that. But there's the engine. We'll talk about that a little later. I just want to show you. Down here's my 1943, just to show you that box. The UP 1943 is down here on the floor. So I not only have the 1943 unit, but I also now have the George Bush unit. And yes, I am a winner. Not sponsored by Coke, but if they want to send the check, they can. And then you have Athern's really coming out with the painted boxes. Because let me pull up the last two. Norfolk Southern 911 and 6920. So just to show you that, I'm trying not to move around because I want to do everything at my desk. I don't feel like getting out of my chair. It's not because I'm lazy, I just don't want to get out of my chair. So, put that back on the box there without it falling off. But, I don't know how well this camera's going to pick up the detail because my camera screen's a little blurry. So I'll do the best I can. There's the presidential seal. There's the toilet drain there, that little circular tube there, right below it. Got the steps there. They don't look like they're see-through like the SC6Es. You got the anti-climber there. The ditch lights mounted on top of those. MU cables. I don't know what kind of couplers those are. McHenry or Katy, I don't know. I really don't care. A lot of people are picky about the couplers. I really don't give a crap. The UP logo on the nose. The number boards, mounted. The headlight mounted above the windows there. Separately applied grab irons. And I just love the way this blue looks on the silver and white. Really looks good. And if you don't know anything about like trains or like airplanes and are new to like history, whatever. I don't know how to describe this, but this is painted after Air Force One, the presidential airplane. So, in case anyone didn't know why it's painted like this, that's why. Most of y'all should know about that if you're an American citizen. If not, there's your little tip on why it's painted like that. I think that's the satellite dome. I don't know what these are for UP. Again, I don't model UP, I model NS, as you can see up there, my heritage units. So, and the fact that my dad works for NS, so I don't know what these are for UP. But there's the 4141 on the side of the cab. This is the conductor side, the other side is the engineer side. And it has the camera in the window there, that little white thing. So, and yes, the cab roof does come off to show the inside. The engineer seat here, and then the conductor seat here. And the wire going across for the LED lights. So, let me try to do this one-handed here. I gotta switch my hand around. This is really hard. I'm not even gonna make a joke. I could, but I don't want to. And then the exhaust vent there. The I don't know what type of horn it is, because again, I don't. Again, with horns, I don't know types of horns. Okay, I just don't know. I don't care. I'm not that big of a geek with trains. Like people might be like, oh, that's what so and so this is used for. That's this type of horn. Blah blah blah. I don't give a crap. Okay, I really don't. Exhaust. Not exhaust fan. I think those are the dynamic brake fans. I don't know. Well, that's probably what that is. So, and you got separately applied truck detail here. Looking nice. The bell, I think, is on the other side. Then you got the fuel tank gauge side glass, the emergency shutoff valve, and the fuel tank cap there. And the George Bush 41 on the side. Really nice model. If you don't model UP, even if you don't model UP, I would suggest picking one of these up if you have the chance to. Because I'm guessing down the road, since this president passed away, this engine will be worth a lot more money than it is right now when you actually buy it. So if you have the chance, pick one up. Because it's just amazing to have it. It's basically like a piece of history here in your hand, so which is just amazing. But I got this engine because my mom's father is a old western type of guy that has like a southern accent, and George Bush and the son of George Bush both remind me of my mom's father with the western accent, the cowboy gray hair. So that's another reason why I picked this up, because this reminds me of my grandfather on my mom's side. So nice piece of rolling stock or locomotive to add to my collection. So, but you got the American flag on the side. Gotta love America, the greatest country in the world. I love my country. I'll love my country the day I die, and even after that, I'll still love my country. Once an American, always an American. And if you don't like this country, then I don't know. So, I don't know what to say to you. You're living a hard life there. No ditch lights on the back. That's a manufacturer thing for UP or whatever, or like a classified, I don't know what the word I'm looking for is. You guys might know what I mean. Like, it's like road specific details, what I meant to say, for UP. They don't have ditch lights on the back. And I don't think, neither does BNSF, I don't think. And I think CSX kind of is like that, kind of isn't. CSX is a mix of trash, I would say. I'm not saying this is trash. I mean, like, CSX has high mounted headlight, low mounted. Their ditch lights sometimes flash when the horn sounds, sometimes don't. Their sticker units are just bull crap. They don't even put in effort. They said put a sticker on, that's good enough. So if you're a CSX fan, then you probably have a mental disorder. I'm just saying, because they, at least UP and NS, put effort into their engines and everything, instead of just slapping a sticker on the side and saying good enough. So but the other side, the engineer side, is basically the same as the other side. Got Old Glory there on the back of the engine.
So
it looks real nice. The radiator fans, the brake wheel there. More fuel tank detail with the air tanks there for the horn. The brake calipers, whatever, or cylinders, I think they're called. I don't know what that little box there is for. So, and then I think the bell should be somewhere on the side. Yeah, I think that's it there. This is the first time looking at it up close. Oh, I see the bell right there. Right there's the bell. I was looking further back here where it usually is. But nice truck detail. You have the word SC70 ACE right there in white as it just went out of focus. I almost had it. How dare you? I think, yeah. I'm trying. This camera is not the greatest. I think that's as good as it's going to get. But you see right there, right at the corner of that seam there where the railing is, but down a thin white stripe. So, and as a Building America Union Pacific logo, 4141, presidential seal, locomotive marking there, who made the engine at the bottom right corner. So, just an awesome looking locomotive. So, Athern did an awesome job. I know MTH will be making this, but MTH, in my opinion, everyone should know, I hate MTH. MTH locomotives are trash. Because of that big coupler on the MTH engines, I don't like to having to replace those big, like O-gauge style looking couplers. That's just a deal breaker for me. I don't like that. And plus, Athern, my main two companies that I go for with engines is Athern, Intermountain. Skeletrains is okay. They just don't make anything good, like their tunnel motors and everything, and their turbines, that's just bull crap. I don't model that junk. I model new era stuff. So if they were to make something like the correct version of the AC6 or AC44 C6Ms or the SC70 ACCs or the Norfolk Southern SC60Es, something new in this era, I would go for, but they just don't. So Skeletrains, I have nothing against Skeletrains. I know Shane personally. It just, they don't have anything in my interest so far, so. But that's gonna do it for this review. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. And I'm not gonna end the video yet, cause why not bring 1943 up? So that's gonna end the video now. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.